So I was trying to think how to present the situation to two people, I didn't get the people with these, or maybe get an interesting problem. But this is, some guy, remember his name, Salmos, we'll be using to make this, for complex devices, but the real thing that we like about wireless technology is that we have communications all the time anywhere. And one of the things that satellite can do for you is it can create connectivity in a wireless fashion anywhere. So with basically three satellites around the Earth and three Earth stations interconnected, you know, in any place on the Earth, possibly essentially New York itself, over actually launching negative wave energy to communicate the electrical. And so we try to take advantage of that unique capability of the satellite solution to make sure that wireless technologies are available everywhere under every circumstance. That has aspects that are important when you worry about homeland security. It has aspects that are important when you worry about bridging the digital divide and providing communication to places that are, don't happen today and therefore don't share the economic development of the world. I got to skip this stuff because I'm not appropriate comment on some of this stuff. The bottom line is in creating solutions, so we're a solution-based company, and creating solutions, we try to take advantage of the knowledge base we have and the assets we have. We have the ability to reach any place in the world from our network, and we have a whole bunch of engineers that grew up in the satellite world. And one unique piece of our world is if you go way back in the early days of communication, you really created specialized networks for every application that you're trying to transport in networks. We had a specialized network that carried voice telecommunications. You had another network that carried broadcast telecommunications. And each of those networks was really fine-tuned to the application that was being transported. When you started to launch satellites to create the kind of coverage that we wanted, and then we tried to take those applications and pass them through this network, which is kind of a generalized network now, because we didn't specialize a satellite network, we ran into all kinds of problems. So a bunch of satellite engineers who grew up in this world, like Ray Hill, as old as I am, we're constantly faced with the fact that every application that we look at really doesn't work when we try to make it pass through a satellite system because of the unique characteristics of the technology. So we have to understand everything there is to know about that application. In the digital world, in the packet-based world, with all the protocols that are being used, and the impact of the delay on the protocol, the jitter on the protocol, the noise characteristics, and the noise correction characteristics of the channel that we're using. So the bottom line is you have a bunch of generalists that understand a lot, a little bit about a lot of different kinds of things, and therefore can create solutions. A lot of times the solutions get a little complex, and we offer them in what we call managed network services. We also offer them in the form of a systemized software company. So we came up with this idea many years ago. We got into this whole process because there was a war going on in Angola. And the Angola oil company said, well, you know, we still like to do business during the middle of this war. We want to be able to communicate and we want to run a trade with London on our GSM phones. Except the problem we have is we've got these facilities that we can protect from the ongoing war, but we can't protect the land in between. So we have a bunch of isolated sites that weren't exist in the first world. Be able to communicate with London and do everything they normally used to doing, and how are we going to connect those sites? Well, we're going to connect them by satellite. It's easy to do. I have one point of presence in an isolated site and connect to a satellite. But then they said, well, we want to use the GSM system. We want a common system designed for the application that fits 90% and doesn't worry about the last 10% of those unusual places where it has to go. So we committed to try to solve that problem and create a network that will operate over a satellite to backhaul, do the communication links that are in the middle of this protocol exchange in a different way, forcing you to learn about the communication protocols and fix them up so they all work. We do this, we are seen by many as a bunch of integration engineers that go out to expanded products. and make them work in a slightly different situation. But actually, to accomplish that, it takes a team of people and a set of laboratories and a set of software tools that allow you to look in detail at every device and every protocol that you're handling to find a way to make you do what you want to do. We have a couple teams like this. It's one of the things I'm doing in my life is manage those teams. I don't know why those guys have all, know all the things, but end up having to represent what they're doing. So we're talking about this. So as a result of this, we're not selling the product. We didn't open a selling industry, but we've done a lot of first. We created the first network that had the AVIS, which is the backbone inside the wireless protocol between the base stations, which is the point of contact to the interface to the user, and the base station controller, which is the aggregation point of the network. And so we were the first people to do that in 1995, and we saw the very specific problem that we talked about. And then as the satellite world is progressing and the cellular world is progressing, the cellular world started thinking about, well, we don't want to think of this cellular world as a very unique network, unique protocol, and because we'd like to really start moving in the direction where there's some convergence with reduced standard types of protocols. And the thinking in what's called 3G, people have probably heard that term if you're around cellular stuff, is that I really want to create a network that looks a lot more like an IP network, whereas I can distribute elements anywhere in the network that I want to distribute them. We're all going to communicate in a convergence layer, which in the IP world is an IP packet-based protocol. I'm going to take my applications, I'm going to fix them up so that they can flow through that world, share the effort of the transport layer, and operate at the edges of the network and create a communication system. So as that was being developed, we ended up being the first guys to create and develop a satellite-based 3G, which is a packet-based distributed network concept. And we did that in time. We actually won an award from GSM conference for the most innovative cellular system in the world. That was kind of interesting since we were a cellular guy, right? So, and the third first we're involved in right now is a network that we're doing right now in Alaska. We take the concept we talked about before, and I distribute all these elements. They're interdependent. Certain functions happen in certain places. Like in places like Alaska, there's a big storm that came in there for 6 months until the tundra freezes again. If I cut off my satellite connectivity, because I want that place to still survive, and because I can't get there, if I want to make change in the radio system, or even want to change the air interface and go from CDMA to GSM to Wi-Fi, I can do all those things remotely. So the last level of burst that we're working on right now is a network that combines all the 3G elements with the concept of software-defined radio, where I download the air interface. Now, it's not a specific chip that I have in the radio set. If I have a GSM system and we want to move it to Wi-Fi or LTE's come along, and I want to use CoFDM for my air interface, well, I write the programs I need to write to create that radio. I download, and that site now becomes a CoFDM. So if we think of it, we're trying to solve a general problem. I want to communicate anywhere, all the time, I want to do right now. So now I'm in Mars, and it takes me like 3 weeks to get there, right? And I want to have, and everybody's gone to LTE, it's a new waveform. Right? Well, you could download that waveform to the base station so that when you show up with your LTE device, it works. You don't have to go there anymore. So that is one of the first to this network. The second first to this network is the fact that if I cut this thing off from the rest of the world, it's still here on Mars and work all by itself. At least the guys on Mars will be able to talk to each other over this common device that was designed to be very inexpensive and to provide communications to everybody for very low cost. The handset, of course, in a network that has millions of users, this is the cost, right? All the big switches and everything, so they're low. The cost is here. I got 100 million of these devices, and it costs $5 more to do what the cost of the terminal. So, the whole concept of what we've been doing, this looks like the same slide. This is a network that we talked about winning an award for. So now we talk about a convergence layer. So one of the things that we do is say, okay, we can reach anywhere satellite network.